Hello, welcome to this session. I'm David, I'm French. You can hear that probably. So I'm going to speak about how you can index your Office document with the Elastic Stack and another project which I'm writing named FS Crawler for File System Crawler. So if you want to extract meaningful information from PDF document and Office document, you have this super nice library in Java named Apache Tika, which is super useful, and you can extract data from many formats like described here. So for that, you have to write a piece of code which is super easy. You have an input stream. From that, you parse this stream, and then you can get back the extracted text with the handler, and then also some metadata like the title, keywords, and things along those lines, and many other metadata things. To do that with Elasticsearch, we have a plugin for that named Ingest Attachment Plugin. Basically, it comes within what we call an ingest pipeline. So an ingest pipeline is made to transform a JSON document that you send to Elasticsearch on the fly before being indexed into Elasticsearch. So how does it work? For example, with this document where we have only one field here, this message field, we send it through an ingest pipeline, and we can use the dissect processor, which is going to extract the label part and the timestamp, and then a lowercase processor, which is going to lowercase the label field, for example. And then that document will be indexed at the end into Elasticsearch. With that, we have a plugin named Ingest Attachment, which is using Apache Tika behind the scene as we saw it. So if you are on-premise, you just have to install the plugin, or if you are using Elastic Cloud, which I'm using here for the demo, you just have to click the option and deploy the plugin with your instance. How does it work? So let me show you that. So I have here my instance already deployed and with everything that I need on Elastic Cloud. And with that, what I can do, I can define an ingest pipeline named here attachment. And for this ingest pipeline, I will use here the attachment plugin. And I'm saying to Elasticsearch, extract the meaningful information using Apache Tika from the field named data. And also remove this binary content that I don't need anymore. So let me create this pipeline. And then you need to provide as a JSON document, because Elasticsearch picks JSON here, the Base64 encoded version of the binary document that you want to index. So here I'm not sending anything, so there is nothing to extract. But if I'm trying to get the information I need here, so I can do Base64, I think that's the command, docs, and what is the name of the test? I have a small one, full text. So here I have a Base64 version of the full text, and the full text contains, where is that? Here. Nothing super interesting, but okay, this text. So let me paste this Base64 content here and send that. So here, as you can see, we are extracting some information like the language here, the content type, the content that we saw, and the content length. No more than that, so that's okay. I have here written a small script, which is exactly doing the same thing. So I'm doing simulate test and foo.txt. So this is doing exactly the same things, calling the ingest pipeline API that we saw, and then seeing the response here. So we have the same thing. If we look at what we have here as examples, I can send, for example, this image. So there is an image here. As you can see, I'm sending a lot of content. So this is the Base64 version of my image. But what you can see, I'm not extracting anything. Why it is? Because the ingest attachment plugin cannot do OCR on the file. So that's the reason we are not able to extract anything. If I'm opening the document, oh, trust me, actually, there is some text inside the document. I can try this, sorry, done, with a bigger file. So let's say, for example, I have a big PDF document here. And this is going to send a lot of content into Elasticsearch, and then we need to wait to parse the response. So basically what is happening here, over the wire, we are sending a lot of data, which is the Base64 representation of our document. And normally, we should expect a response from Elasticsearch. So Elasticsearch has to hold that information in memory, then stream that to Apache Tika, then generate a JSON document. So we are basically overloading the heap of the Elasticsearch instance. And we are extracting the information, but not that many, actually. If we have sent only the text, that would be easier to send directly the text. So that's basically what the file system crawler project is doing. Instead of sending the binary document to Elasticsearch, we are trying to extract the document directly from the machine where we have collected the document. So this project is now kind of popular. I started that in 2010, something like that. Important thing. Although I'm working at Elastic, this project is not supported by Elastic, so this is a community project that I'm working aside. So what is the architecture of a file system crawler? So basically, you have an input layer, filter layer, an output layer. If you know Logstash, this is super similar to what we have in Logstash. So you can read documents and binary documents from the local directory, from a shared directory, over SSH or over FTP as well. And there is also a REST interface where you can upload to FS crawler a binary document, and then the magic will happen. What kind of magic do we have? Nothing. If you have a JSON document, we do nothing, we just send the JSON document to Elasticsearch. If you have an XML document, we can read the XML document, transform that to JSON document, and then send that to Elasticsearch. But here, what we are using as well is the same code that you have seen previously, which is using Apache Tika. So we are doing the extraction directly on the machine where we are collecting the PDF document or the Office document. And then we are sending that to Elasticsearch. The thing with that is that we are not limited by what the team has decided to support within the ingest attachment plugin. We are supporting all the Tika format that Tika can hold. And also, more importantly, we can support OCR as well. So if you have Tesseract running on your machine, it will do the TCR transformation as well. We used to have much more metadata, but now there is a pull request that has been merged in the ingest attachment plugin, so it's not true anymore. And we have language detection out of the box. And this is also the same thing, actually, in Elasticsearch with the ingest attachment plugin. So there is some documentation and things like that. So when I started to write this project, I wanted at the end to write a UI over FS crawler to provide a search box for this project and for Elasticsearch. But then recently, 2 years ago or 3 years ago, we joined forces with another team, and this team provided enterprise search solution, on top of Elastic Stack. And this solution provides a UI, and I'm not good at all at writing UIs. So I said, okay, with this project being available for free within the basic license, I'm saying, okay, I don't need to write myself a UI, I'm going just to use that. So the name of this project is Workplace Search, and basically what you can do, instead of sending the document to Elasticsearch, you can actually send now the document to Workplace Search and benefit to all the things that you can have with Workplace Search. So I'm going to show you that now. So if you look at Workplace Search, this is this project here. So I have already two sources. So with Workflex Search, basically, you can have a federated search on top of all the documents that you have within your companies. Here, I have an input, a source which is Dropbox. So I have some data available on Dropbox. I have also a source on GitHub, but it could be your Gmail, your Google Drive, your all the things that you can imagine. And if you don't have a source for it, so you can add here, so you have multiple sources that are available. And if you don't have that, you can use the custom API source. And basically, FSCrawler is using this endpoint to send the data to the workplace search thing. So how does it work? I think I have here another tab open. So you can start FSCrawler. I have already the configuration done. And I'm going to launch the job number one here, where I set the definition, when I said, okay, send all the data that you are going to extract, not to Elasticsearch anymore, but to Workplace Search. And this is what you see in debug mode here. I have a lot of documents in my directory, and everything is sent to Workplace Search. Apparently, it worked. Let's see that. So if I look at the source again, so now I have this. So this is coming from my local directory. I have those 26 documents. Okay. So what can I see here? Yes, it has been synced. And okay. I can look at the content. So those are the documents that I have been indexed. By default, FSCrawler is managing the schema. Like, okay, created at is a date, and I don't know, size is a number and things like that, so you don't have to think about that. It also provides a default way to display the results, but if you want to adapt this, then you can just change it if you wish. Okay, let's do that and save. Why not? Same for the details. All those is provided by default. And then you can just go to your search application and search within all those sources. So here I have the content from the local file, Dropbox and GitHub. If I'm searching for something here. So you have this nice search UI that I'm not able to beat myself, but it's here. And you can navigate through the result. For example, if I'm choosing Dropbox, then I can choose also the PDF documents in Dropbox and things like that. So here I'm going to just look at David on local files, for example. Here, I have this test OCR. You remember this one? So now you can see that we have extracted some content, actually. So OCR is working out of the box. And if I'm clicking on that, I have the details. And if I'm clicking here, it will open the document. Why it's going to open the document? Because behind the scene, I'm running a HTTP server, which is serving my documents, my local documents. There is no magic here. It's not in Elasticsearch. It serves from the local part. I think that's all what I have for today. So if you want to contribute to the project, there are a lot of issues open. Please, if you are a Java developer, come help me. And if you try the project, please give me also some feedback. And if you have any issues, I will be super happy to get your issues and try to fix that. Thank you all. Have a good day.